I'm going to share with you how to add thumbnails to your YouTube videos, and I'm going to share my thumbnail creation process with you. In this video, I'm going to show you three ways to add a thumbnail to your YouTube videos. The first way I'm going to show you is how to add a custom thumbnail when you're uploading a new video to your channel. The second way I'm going to show you is how to change a thumbnail on a video that's already on your channel. And the third way that I'm going to share with you is how to change your custom thumbnail using your iPhone or Android phone. By creating better thumbnails, you'll increase the click-through rates on your videos, helping you get more views. Carl here from DM with Carl, helping you start and grow an audience on YouTube. Let's not waste another second and get right into it. When you're uploading a new video to YouTube, it's really important that you do choose a custom thumbnail to upload on your video. Let me show you how to do that. From your YouTube channel page, we're going to click on the upload video button. Then we're going to choose our video file that we're going to upload. Once your new video has started uploading, you can scroll to the bottom and select custom thumbnails. Then you can choose the file that you want to use as your custom thumbnail. Once your custom thumbnail has finished uploading, it will appear on the bottom right hand side. If you have the custom thumbnail dimensions correct, you will have this little red box around your custom thumbnail. The correct dimensions for a YouTube thumbnail are 1280 by 720 pixels. If this custom thumbnail button isn't here, it's because your YouTube account isn't yet verified. I'll show you how to get your channel verified, but first, let me show you how to change the thumbnail on a video that's already on your channel. From your YouTube Studio dashboard, head down on the left-hand tab and select Videos. Then we're going to choose the video where you want to change your thumbnail. Click on the video title to go into the editing suite. And below the description, you're going to see your thumbnail that you currently have and the three other thumbnails. Scroll onto your current thumbnail and click on the three dots for the options. And we're going to select Change Thumbnail. Then you can choose your new custom thumbnail that you would like for your video. Once your thumbnail has finished uploading and your new thumbnail is on your video, don't forget to head up to the top right-hand side and click on Save before you exit out. If you want to change your custom thumbnail using your iPhone or Android phone, then this third process is for you. To get started, you're going to need to download the YouTube Studio app. Head into your App Store or into the Google Play Store and search for YT Studio and open up YouTube Studio. Check that it is from Google LLC, and then you can download the app. Once the app's downloaded, open it up and we're going to go to the top left hand menu and we're going to select Videos. Choose the video that you want to edit the thumbnail for by clicking on it, and then we're going to click on the pencil in the top right hand side. Once the video is loaded, you're going to select Edit Thumbnail in the middle of the image and click Change on the left hand side. Choose the image you want as your new thumbnail and then hit Select on the top right. And then hit Save again on the top right. This will save your changes and your thumbnail will be updated from your phone. If your YouTube channel is new and you don't yet have the option to add a custom thumbnail, go to your status and features to check if your YouTube account is verified. To check this, go to youtube.com/features. I'll leave a link for you in the description below. Next to your channel icon, if you don't have the blue verified tick, then you need to verify your account. Go to youtube.com/verify and follow the two-stage verification process. If you can't get verified this way, have a look at our full video here that takes you step by step through the verification process. Then come back to your status and features and under the custom thumbnails section, click enable. If you're interested in getting started on YouTube, but you don't know where to begin, the best place to start is the free YouTube masterclass by Sean Cannell. Have a look at the link in the description below and get started building your online influence today. I'm now going to share with you our thumbnail creation process and explain to you why Photoshop and Lightroom are the best tools to create the best thumbnails for your channel to increase your click-through rate and get you more views.
What I want you to do is I want you to step up your custom thumbnail game, and I want you to take specific intentional photos that you can use as your custom thumbnail. This is going to make all the difference in increasing your click-through rate, which is going to help you eventually get more views to your videos. So I want you to take a photograph of you in the environment that you're going to be doing the video. So like I am right here doing the video for you, I'm going to then take a photograph in this environment that I can use as the custom thumbnail. The first option and the easiest option for you is to just grab your phone, and you can then use this to take a selfie that you can use as your custom thumbnail. The second and my preferred option is to use your main camera that you normally use to film your videos to take the photograph. The quality on an SLR or the camera that you're using to film your videos is going to be much higher than that of your cell phone. But if you really want to do selfies on your phone, then you can do this, and it's an excuse for you to get into that selfie mode. So if you are going to use your phone to take this photograph, make sure that you're framing it in the way that you want your thumbnail to look. So if you want to work on the rule of thirds, where you want yourself on the left-hand side or the right-hand side of the image, make sure that you're framing yourself in the selfie in this way so that you can use it exactly like you want it in your custom thumbnail to get the best possible custom thumbnail. So make sure you're positioning yourself the way you want to, and make sure that when we're taking these kind of photographs, I really want you to show a lot of expression on your face and show a bit of fun. This is what's going to capture people's attention and make them want to click on your thumbnail. Make sure it's relevant for your video, so don't pull a shocking face when you're doing an educational video and it's just an interesting video, so that your thumbnail is an accurate description of what's actually in your video. Let's get into selfie mode. Now, one of the things that you might want to do is if you want to use a whole lot of text in your image, you can shape your hand so it looks like you're holding the text. Or if you want to have an object in your thumbnail, then you can put your hand so that's exactly where you want to put the object or the text to be read. So get into your perfect pose, and then you can start taking your images exactly how you want them. Now, don't be too nervous to get up, move around, so that you can get the perfect shot. Make sure you have good lighting and it's not too dark in the environment that you want to take the photograph. Now that you've got the photograph for your thumbnail, the second step is for us to import the photo into your laptop, and we're going to take it into Lightroom to do a bit of basic editing. So let's get into Lightroom.
So we've imported all the photographs that we took with our selfie camera and our main camera into Lightroom, and now we're going to get into editing them. One thing I do want you to remember when you're taking these photographs is think about the shadows that you're creating when you're holding your selfie, and make sure you take enough photographs. Like you can see here, I was closing my eyes or there was a bit of shake. So always make sure that you're taking a lot. Don't hold back. I know some of you are selfie queens, so you should be fine. But for those of you that aren't used to it, just take lots of photographs. And then I want you to have a look at the difference between the quality that'll come out of a cell phone compared to the difference in quality if you're taking it on an SLR camera. So you can see how much better it blurs the background. I have used a bit of a cleaner background for this. I just shifted over to the right a tiny bit. So think about what's in your background. I found this TV quite distracting when I could see it on my SLR screen while I was taking the photograph. So I shifted over to the left a tiny bit. Tiny bit cleaner background, but it just looks so much better. And then you can see I'm trying the expressions that we spoke about. So I think I'm going to go with this one. I like that expression. It's going to the develop module, and we're going to do some very basic editing. I'm going to make it slightly warmer. I'm going to brighten it a bit, tiny bit dark. Increase the contrast. We want to go quite high on the contrast of the shadows a bit. So we get all those colors coming through, and then our clarity and sharpness we want to increase. And then the last thing I want to do is add some vibrance and that little bit of oversaturation. We don't want to overdo it. I don't want you to go into a different color skin, but we want to add a bit just so the photo starts to pop a tiny bit out of there. So that should be good, maybe a tiny bit more clarity, and then we can just sharpen the image a bit. Get some of that sharpening, maybe a tiny bit of noise reduction, which you don't really need. But there's some very, very basic changes there. And what I'm going to do for you guys is I'm going to save a preset just for you called YouTube 1000 Lightroom Preset. And there'll be a link to this preset in the description below, so you can just paste those settings and then make small adjustments as you see fit. So if you have a look, once you import a photograph on your side, now you can see the difference between the edit that we've made and the normal photograph. And then you can just click on the preset and you're pretty much done. Maybe you can make some small adjustments, so maybe the exposure can come down a tiny bit there. But other than that, I'm quite happy with how that photograph looks. Once you're done, you can then export your picture, and we're going to then import it into Photoshop. Once we're in Photoshop, we're going to create a new file. And what I want you to do is do a 1920 by 1080. And we're going to have a resolution of 72. So the dimensions for your custom thumbnails are 1920 by 1080. That's what YouTube accepts. So that's what I want you to put in when you're creating your new file. The other option is you can download this template, the custom thumbnail template. I'll have a download link in the description below. And you can just open this file and then use this file to create your very own custom thumbnails. Now you might want to change the background color that I use. I also use a different font that I've imported from Adobe. It's called Bebas Nue, but if you want to, you can just change this to any font that you want to use and make sure it's how you want your custom thumbnail to look so that it is a unique look for yourself. So we're going to open the image that we've just edited in Lightroom. I'm going to use the magnetic lasso tool to draw a line very roughly. This doesn't have to be perfect around the edge. The nice thing is if you've taken this photo correctly, then the background will be blurry and you'll be in focus. So it should be quite easy for Photoshop to pick up the edges that you want to trace around and just get a rough. Don't take too long doing this, and I'm not very accurate at doing this, so you can miss a few edges, and I'll show you how to fix that up. So you get the rough outline of where you are, and then what we're going to do, head over here and choose the quick selection tool, and you'll see there's a plus and a minus. So if we need to add anything, I like to zoom in to about 200%, and then we can really have a look at anything that we've missed on the sides. We've missed the side of my shirt here, and we can just add that back in by scrolling over the parts that we want added in, and that'll add that back in, and you can do this in detail. I'm going to fast forward so we have all of this added. What you can do if you want to take away, you can go to the minus and then just take away any parts that you don't need added on there. And you can go back to plus to add on. So I'm going to fast forward to once we've got this perfectly selected. Okay, so I'm quite happy with that. Then we can zoom back out and go Command C to copy it. And then Command V to paste it on the other side. Now remember, it's going to be high quality. So we're going to have to pull that and resize it to fit our thumbnail. There we are, now we have a nice image that fits our thumbnail, and I'm just going to move this text over to the right. So I'm actually only going to use two words. I can remove that. And what I want to do is add a blend to my picture just to make it stand out. So I'm going to go to blending options and click on outer glow. And you'll see here I've got a spread of 13 and a size 49, the opacity at 93, and I'm using white. So it just gives it that nice glow so that I stand out from the background. And now make sure that the text that you're using is not exactly the same as your title, but it must be enticing and get the people to think about what's in your video. So I want it to be accurate and just use two, maybe three words that will get them to think about what's in the video and offer them a solution and think about clicking on your video in order to watch it. Once you're happy with your text, then you can export your file, go export as, and we're going to save it as a JPEG. And export your custom thumbnail. Now, if you want to change the background color, you can go in here and choose the paint bucket tool and change the color if you want it to look different. You can make this any color that you want, depending on what kind of theme you have for your channel. But think about what's going to stand out in the search results and what's going to look good for you. Now, for those of you that don't have Photoshop and Lightroom, I'll leave a link below in the description to a video where I will show you how to download the free trial, and then you can then use this free trial to create your custom thumbnails. If you're interested in getting started on YouTube, but you don't know where to begin, the best place to start is the free YouTube masterclass by Sean Cannell. Have a look at the link in the description below and get started building your online influence today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.